Welcome to episode 66 of the 3M Fear podcast. There was an air of mystery about the house where Kadal Jensen Raja lived. The family had a strange rule. No servants or family members were allowed upstairs where the family lived. They only came downstairs to eat, and after meals, the leftover food was placed in a cover on the staircase for someone to collect. Kadal Jensen Raja was a loner. He didn't have many friends, which always worried his family. He lived with his 58-year-old mother, Dr. Jean Padma, his 60-year-old father, Raja Tangam, his 25-year-old sister, Carolyn, and his 70-year-old relative named Lalita. One day, while browsing the internet, Kadal stumbled upon the concept of astral projection. The idea captivated him, and he couldn't stop reading about it. He spent hours in his room, deeply reading and researching on this topic. Little did anyone know that this fascination would lead to a tragic turn of events. Kadal Jensen Raja, at the age of 30, was accused of committing a horrific crime. He was charged with the murder of his entire family, his mother, father, sister, and his relative. Hello and welcome to the 3AM Fear podcast. I'm Nikita Ferrao, mystery and thriller author. On this podcast, I talk about real crimes and real people. Due to the graphic nature of some of this content, listener discretion is advised. You can find the episode show notes on my website 3amfear.com. Let's get started. So what is astral projection? Astral projection is a belief that people can leave their physical bodies and travel in a non-physical form. Let's just say it is a deep form of meditation. You are in this deep meditative state when you are able to push your soul out of your body and then you can roam wherever you want. No one will be able to see you, no one will be able to talk to you, but you can see and talk to anyone. Now, how did I come about this explanation? This is the simplest form of explanation that I can give. It kind of gives you a feeling of floating or flying outside your body while no one else can see you. Now, I recently published my book, The Twisted Secret, and this whole book is about astral projection. It's about my main character who's in a car accident and the person in the other car is in a coma, and somehow this person manages to push their soul out of their body, and now only my main character can see them. They can walk around, they can talk to my main character, they can see everything, but they can't react. Kadal was fascinated by astral projection. In his room, he would spend hours in front of the computer, creating video games filled with violence, blood, and gore. This dark hobby matched his growing obsession with astral projection. It kind of gave him a dopamine rush, and he would spend days alone in his room trying to perform astral projection. Now, whether he was actually successful or not, it's not known. Kadal's father had high hopes for his son's future. He was like any other father. He wanted his son to study and get a really good job. But Kadal struggled academically, and he was not interested in higher education. Desperate to see him succeed, his father sent him abroad to study MBBS. The plan was for Kadal to become a doctor, just like his mother. But after just 1 year, he dropped out and returned home. His parents did not stop there. They pushed him to study engineering. Unfortunately, Kadal dropped out of that program also. By now, his parents were increasingly worried because according to them, he was only interested in video games. But to be honest, he was interested with astral projection. And no one knew that. One day, everything changed. Cadel came to his parents and told them that he wanted to go to Australia to study artificial intelligence. For his family, this was a glimmer of hope. Their son, who had nearly given up at this point, now wanted to study. Now, if you know Indian parents, especially the previous generation, you know that they are never going to agree for artificial intelligence. But with Cadel, it was a different story. Cadel had dropped out of MBBS, he had dropped out of engineering, and it was as if for his father, it was this or nothing, and his father just wanted him to study. And so his father agreed. A few years go by, and Cadel called home one day with good news. He had just secured a good job in Australia, and he was now coming back home. His parents were overjoyed. Their daughter had also found a good job in China and was planning to come home too. The parents felt a sense of pride and relief because both their children were now financially stable. The reality was very different. Cadel would spend hours alone in his room, not working as his parents thought, but he was deepening his obsession with astral projection. His fascination grew stronger, and now he was not just doing astral projection, but he was also performing other rituals. On April 5th, 2017, 29-year-old Cadel made a horrifying decision. He decided to kill his entire family. Cadel carefully planned this horrifying act. He always felt like an outcast in his accomplished family, and so he decided to take these drastic measures. According to the police, Cadel confessed that he killed all four family members of his by delivering fatal blows to their heads. He said that he purchased two axes online that were used in the crime. Now, talking about why Cadel hated his family so much. His family was well educated and successful. His father was a college professor, his mother was a doctor, and his sister had just returned home after completing her medical degree in China. If you look at Cadel, he is a college dropout. He had been sent abroad to study medicine, then engineering, and then artificial intelligence. He dropped out of two. Now, I'm not sure whether he actually completed his artificial intelligence study or not. On April 5, 2017, Cadel went to his mother and asked her if she could come to his room and see the video game that he had just created. She was happy. Her son had finally done something. When she went to his room, he asked her to sit in front of the computer. As she waited for the game to begin, she suddenly felt a sharp pain shooting through her head. Her son had just struck her with an axe. But that's not all. As she fell on the keyboard, Cadel kept hitting her with the axe till he was sure that she was dead. Once he was sure that she was dead, he cleaned the blood off the floor with phenyl and then dragged her body into the bathroom. Acting as if nothing had happened, Cadel went downstairs and waited for his father and sister to come home. It is said that he was totally calm during the whole process, even when he was killing his mother. When his father and sister returned, he invited his father upstairs to his room once again to show the video game. Now, his father was not as interested as his mother, but after much persuasion, he agreed. Cadel took him upstairs and made him sit in the exact same place as his mother. While he was watching the game, he struck and killed his father with the axe. Now, after killing his father, he didn't want to repeat the same process of cleaning the floor because it was taking too much time. And so he decided to go and call his sister. As soon as she entered the room, he struck her with the axe. But unfortunately, Carolyn didn't die immediately. She just fell on the floor. Cadel got a machete and brutally cut her throat with it. Now, in that house, there was also his relative who was there. The question arises, how did she not hear any of these things? I mean, there must have been noises, screams, things being moved around. It is said that there was some sort of a music playing and that's why she didn't hear anything. But once again, we are not sure because at this time, in this house, there was just Cadell and his relative who was 70 years old. Cadell had ordered 5 plates of food that night and he ate dinner with his aunt. It is unknown to what he told her when it was only the two of them. After dinner, he went to his room to sleep, all while having the dead bodies of his family members lying in his bathroom floor. Allegedly, for the next 2 days, he was busy cutting the body parts of his family to discard them. They also had a maid who was on leave and now she had returned. Upon returning, she asked Cadell where the rest of the family were. And he said that everyone went to Kanyakumari except for his aunt because she couldn't. For the coming 2 days, the maid came to the house, did the housework and left without knowing what was happening in the house. Now why? Cadell's room was on the first floor and no one was allowed into his room. So how did she not smell anything? No one knows the answer to that. On 9th, when the maid came home, she realized that Lalita was not at home. When she asked Cadell, he said that she too had gone to Kanyakumari. Which meant Cadell had finally killed his last family member. Cadell now wanted to get rid of the bodies. And the best way that he could think of was to light them on fire. He then attempted to burn the bodies in the upstairs bathroom, but the fire spread too quickly around the house. Neighbors noticed the smoke and alerted the fire department. Realizing that he was now in danger, Cadell fled the house. Witnesses saw him running past a nearby house and hiding when the smoke started to rise. When the police recovered the bodies, they also found a dummy body along with them, leading them to suspect that Cadell had something to do with it. It seemed as if Cadell wanted to prove that he also died in that fire. This would have prevented anyone from searching for him. After committing the murders, Cadell managed to evade the police and moved around the town swiftly. He escaped to Chennai but later returned to Thiruvananthapuram where he was caught by the police at the Central Railway Station. It was easy for the police to identify him because of his long hair and distinctive features. Also, Cadell was trying to cover his face with his hair. Cadell never openly confessed to why he killed his family. During the interrogation, he said that he wanted to separate their soul from their body and astral projection was the way. Upon further questioning, the police found out that Cadell hated his family, especially his father, because his father didn't consider him to be a brilliant child compared to his other family members. His sister studied to become a doctor, while Cadell couldn't complete his MBBS or engineering. And we all know how Indian parents can be when it comes to education. Not being mean, but you know what I'm talking about. The police found it strange that Cadell's aunt stayed in the same house for 3 days after the murders and before she was killed. Now, after the investigation, the police somehow believed his second story, which was he hated his father, not the one where he wanted to do the ritual. Because when they searched his house, they found the burnt dummy, which meant that he already purchased a dummy and it was not a spur of the moment action. When they checked Cadell's internet history, they found multiple video links where he had searched and watched how to kill and discard a body. He had also bought petrol and kept in the house to burn the bodies. This answers why he killed his father and mother. But why the other two? When the police asked him, he said he didn't want them to be alone in this world. The court ordered an investigation to see if Cadell had any mental health issues before the murders. In the first 6 years of his imprisonment at Pujapura Central Jail, only one person visited him, his mother's brother, Jose. However, later Jose also would stop visiting. The court eventually found Cadell incompetent to stand trial after doctors testified that he suffered from severe mental illness. Unconfirmed, police reports indicated that psychiatrist had diagnosed him with schizophrenia. that is, a mental disorder that affects a person's thinking, feeling, and behavior. Cadell had been suffering from this disorder for several years, and he had not received any form of treatment. When he was in jail, he would say that there is a voice that is constantly telling him to kill. Cadell Jensen Raja is now in solitary confinement at Pujapura Central Jail in Thiruvananthapuram. In January of 2018, he was rushed to the hospital after being found in his cell with froth in his mouth, indicating that he had suffered an epileptic seizure. Cadell's story is a reminder of the dangers of hidden obsessions and untreated mental illness. It is not easy to know when someone is suffering from a mental illness, but sometimes there are some clues. His fascination with astral projection and the brutal murders of his family left a lasting impact on everyone who knew him. It is said that there is crore's worth of property left behind by his parents, but there is no one to claim it. Because unfortunately, the last living heir of the family is the one who destroyed the family. A point to be noted here, most of the photos if you see of Cadell, you will see him smiling, happy, even when he was in court or when he was taken to prison or when he was handcuffed and taken by the police, he is always smiling. He never once regretted what he did. He never once said that what he did was wrong or that there was any other way he could have stopped it. This was the story of Cadell Jensen Raja. A big thank you to all my fellow listeners who have been listening and supporting this episode. Your reviews, your listens mean a lot. If you love this episode, if you love the stories that I put out, then please do leave a rating on whichever podcasting platform you're listening from. It would really mean the world to me. Other than this, I also have a YouTube and an Instagram page. I'll link it in the description. Do check it out. I have different stories on Instagram, and I'm planning to put out some short horror stories on YouTube, so do subscribe to my YouTube channel and stay tuned. I am also an author, love fiction stories. If you want to check out my free fiction book, I'll link it in the description. I'll also link my other account in the description, where I talk about fiction writing, travel, and I also will soon start sharing fiction stories. So stay tuned. So do follow me there. Thank you so much for everything. That's all for this week. Stay kind, stay safe, and see you next week.